Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go over how to create time frequency plots using Study in EEG Lab. So I have MATLAB open and I'm loading in my version of EEG Lab. I'm assuming in this video that you've already created a study that has the information of all your participants that you want to analyze already created. So I'm going to go to Load Existing Study and load in the study data type, and that loads in the command window. And I have 42 subjects that are being loaded in, and when that's done, it will change the main window and it correctly says that the number of subjects is 42, so that's correct. Now let's go into the actual tutorial of how you create time frequency plots. So I'm going to go up to the menu bar and click Study. The first thing I'm going to do is create a study design. So this is a design that tells EEG Lab what type of analysis and what type of conditions I want to include in my design. So if you look here, I've already created multiple designs, and the way to create a new one is you click Add Design, and that creates a new design at the bottom of the list. If you want to name it something so that you know what it is, you can click Rename Study Design and then type in whatever you want the name to be and click OK. I'm going to delete that design because I already have an example design created. And if I click that, it loads in the variables that I want to use for this particular design. So depending on what type of analysis you want to run, that's going to affect what type of design you run. In my case, I want to load in all my subjects, so all 42 subjects are highlighted in the subjects box. Then what type of variables I want to analyze will be in independent variable 1 and 2. So for my study, for this data that I loaded in, I have a variable called bin label that's labeled with 5 different conditions that were studied during the EEG study. And so when I click that, that loads in. So I want to study the first 4 conditions, and these are repeated measures, so I'm going to call these paired statistics when the analysis is done. And also EEG Lab lets you combine across different levels of a factor. So for example, if I wanted to combine condition 1 and condition 2, you can highlight both and click Combine Selected Values. And once I do that, that will create a variable at the bottom that I then can click, and it includes variable conditions B1 and B2. So for this analysis, I used bin 1, 2, 3, 4, and that will create 4 separate time frequency plots if I do that for just the first variable. And then I added a second variable, which was group. So I grouped by older adults and younger adults, and these are already labeled in the subjects file when they're loaded in. So I'm going to include both that information as well in the analysis, and these are unpaired statistics. So based on the information that I selected, I am going to produce 8 time frequency plots. So I'm going to produce 4 conditions for the older adults and then 4 conditions for the younger adults. And if I want to store this analysis when it's pre-computing or pre-calculating the results, I'm going to select where I want that information stored in a folder. So I've already created an example folder on my desktop and I already ran this analysis. So you select that folder and click Open. Save the study and then click OK. And to click OK, it will create yours or save your study design. So if I click OK, that loads in the command window and the study design was saved. Next, after that, I'm going to go either to pre-compute channel measures or pre-compute component measures. So you can create 2 types of time frequency plots. You can either create one time frequency plot per channel that you have, and you would use pre-compute channel measures for that, or you can create time frequency plots based on principal components. So if you want to do it based on principal components, you would click here, but I'm going to create time frequency plots based on channels. So I'm going to click pre-compute channel measures. When I do that, that opens this window, and this is going to ask me how I want to create the time frequency plots. So this check mark, which is automatically checked when you open the pre-compute measures box, will interpolate missing channels based on the surrounding neighbor channels that have information. And for us, this is where we're going to specify that we want to do a time frequency analysis. So list of measures to pre-compute, it gives you different options. For time frequency plots, we're going to want to pre-compute ERSPs, which stand for event-related spectral perturbations, and the intertrial coherence, or ITC, and then it asks you for time frequency parameters. So this will give you basically the option to customize what your time frequency plots look like when they're output. And if you click the test button, it will give you a sample time frequency plot based on the parameters that you specify. So the way it's specified right now, if it computes a time frequency plot, it would look like this. For creating new time frequency plots in EGLab, this GUI is essentially running a function called newTimeF. And so if you want to know all the possible parameters that you can include in your customized analysis and how those values affect the output or the physical appearance, you can look at the documentation online. So the function is called newTimeF for EGLab, and the scripts are publicly available on GitHub. So this will give a long explanation of all the optional parameters and required parameters that you have to include, and the different options you can input, and how those affect things. So for me, when I create time frequency plots, you saw that I had a bunch of different designs. So usually what I do is I create one folder per design. So I have an example folder. I've already pre-computed, so that's why I have a long folder full of data. And at the top of it, I usually include a text file that has the information of what specific parameters I input into newTimeF. So in this case, I'm going to change this and I'm going to put cycles 3.5, number of frequencies 30, number of times out 200. I think this is the default anyway. Going to put a baseline of negative 700 to negative 200 milliseconds. The frequencies, I want it to go from 4 hertz as the lowest to 30 hertz as the highest. Frequency scale, I want it to be log, and the scale, I want it to be log. So some notes that I wrote, cycles, I've read that the cycles should be between 3 and 14 as the highest, and when you run this command, it will print out in the command window on MATLAB what the cycles were. Frequency scale, the y-axis will be either log or linear, so you have two options for your y-axis. Depending on whether you want to look more at higher frequencies or lower frequencies will change how you want to scale your y-axis. The actual scale parameter asks you if you want power in decibels or absolute power, so usually we want it to be log for decibel power. And number of frequencies, if you set this parameter, it's going to override the parameter pad ratio. So let me go ahead and input that, and I'll show you how that affects the test. So I'm going to put cycles from 3 to 0.5, number of frequencies 30, number of times out 200. And if you put something wrong, it won't let you run the command. So if you click test, it will show an error. Baseline, frequency scale. Okay, so now let me test that to see if I typed out everything correctly. And it looks like I did. So based on the way I am setting my parameters, the time frequency plots are going to look like this. So we have log scaling on the y-axis. The frequencies go from 4 to 30 like I asked it to. Number of time points across is going to be 200, and we have decibel power. So that looks fine to me. So if you click OK, then the MATLAB will start running and creating the ERSPs and the intertrial coherences. I already ran this with this exact setup before, so I'm not going to run it again. What it did was, or what it will do, is produce these files in the folder you specified in your study design, and for each subject, or for each condition and subject pairing, in my case, it's going to create a .ERSP and a .ITC. And so once that's done, now you can plot your time frequency plots. So I'm going to go to study, and I'm going to click plot channel measures. And then that opens this window, and it gives me the option to look at different or all electro channels and different or all subjects. So let me look at PZ, for example, for all subjects. So I'm going to click plot ERSPs, and like I said, that will produce 8 time frequency plots. So it tells you at the top that the first row is older adults, the second row is younger adults, and then these are the 4 conditions that I asked it to output as well. And so this will give you the raw time frequency plots. If you wanted to see, for example, what statistical clusters are significant, then you can go into stats and play around with that. So that gives you different parametric and non-parametric options for finding significant significant clusters or significant pixels, but I'm not going to go into that in this video. All right, so that's pretty much it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.